practice.
Joining us now on Native International, Mr. James Anderson, lead governance specialist in this field, governance global practice in the World Bank. Pleasure, sir, to have you on Native International.
Thank you. My pleasure as well.
Thank you a lot. My question, why is the World Bank interested in the issue of corruption?
Well, the World Bank's mission is to help countries to eliminate poverty and to boost shared prosperity. And we've realized that we can't do this without addressing the scourge of corruption.
Yes.
Corruption which hurts poor people, it misallocates resources, and it inhibits growth.
Yes.
And so we need to address corruption.
So you need to address corruption. But let me say, you are a specialist in a domain such like governance, global practice in the World Bank. So can you speak, can you explain how the World Bank exerts some efforts in order to fighting corruption, in order to strengthen the capabilities of the countries?
Absolutely. So we work with countries on things like open government, increasing transparency, access to information. All of these are institutions which require active support from the government, and also in some cases some technical abilities. We support the use of technology to strengthen the interface between citizens and the government. And it also helps with transparency. We also work with other institutions of accountability, like supreme audit institutions, anti-corruption agencies, et cetera. So actually in quite a large number of different ways, we try to support countries to develop the institutions that make corruption less likely, to prevent it from happening in the first place.
Yes. With this complicated situation, imposed by COVID, imposed by insecurity, especially in this continent of Africa. Yes, to which extent can really corruption be controlled?
Well, we definitely think that improvements can be made, and corruption can be reduced. It cannot be eliminated. It'll never be eliminated completely.
Yes.
But by being more transparent and having stronger institutions of accountability, then it can be controlled. Now, you're right, under the situations of COVID, it does make things more difficult, but it also makes it even clearer how important it is to try to address corruption. We've found that corruption not only hurts poor people, but undermines the ability of states to be able to respond to crises in general, and it also just undermines progress in many areas. When we did a survey asking stakeholders of what are the reasons that important reforms are not carried out, the most important cited reason was corruption.
Yes.
And so we think it's absolutely important to pay considerable attention to this issue.
And it's so important to regain some confidence in the governmental institutions from the point of view of people.
Absolutely, yeah. This is where people get trust. They get trust from their own experiences, but also what they perceive, and the more that corruption undermines that trust, it undermines all sorts of issues and all sorts of ways that the government needs to act.
Yes. Mr. Anderson, thanks a lot for this interview.
Well, thank you very much.